So I'd like to talk about this Mama Raster concept that's going to come in twice. Here we're basically converting a layer that's in a different format than what we've been using into a raster. And here we're basically taking a raster that's kind of much, it's going to wind up being much bigger than our study site, and we have to do reclassify and resample. So I'll talk about this in another video, this idea of resampling, but for right now I want to talk about this master, the Mama raster concept. And to start with, let's just kind of maybe do a little bit of a review. And so we've been dealing a lot with situations like, here we have an object raster, and we do something like, you know, use zonal geometry to calculate the area of it. And then I showed you how if you wanted to get rid of these, the area that's in the kind of the background here, that you could take a Boolean raster, right? So the Boolean version of that object raster, and you could use that Boolean raster to kind of create a mask, right? Because if you multiplied this against this, you would wind up basically kind of dropping a mask over it, because any cell that has a zero value here would erase the value in this guy, right? And any cell that had a one here would preserve it. So it acts like this mask that would then give you that kind of an output, correct? And then, so that was called, you know, let me find something to write down here. Okay, so that was, you know, an example of using, technically we used raster, use some ink. So that was technically when we used raster calculator, but I said more generally that that was an example of a local operation, right? And I used that because what we were doing is comparing values at the same locale across two layers, right? So does that make sense? We're kind of comparing values at each location across an image or across a raster. Does that make sense? So that was the idea of a local operation. Then we did something else. We again started with, I think, this guy. And then we had this, right? So we had our objects. These are our parking lots. We had our distance raster. And what we found is that we could create, you know, use this object raster to create windows that we could then drop on top of our distance raster and then say something about the values in this raster based on the zones in this raster, right? So that we would get something like this. So technically, or specifically, this was what? This was our, I think, zonal statistics in kind of the world of arc. But I said more generally that this was an example of a zonal operation, because here we were creating outputs based on the zones of one of the inputs. Is that right? In this case, it was the zonal values of this was driving that output. Fair enough. Both of these, though, are basically overlay operations. Sorry, that's kind of just trying to get it all to fit in there. But they're overlay in the sense because both of my examples require tracing paper to be able to see, allow you to kind of get the feel for how they worked, because you're overlaying one raster on top of another. And so what these guys, what these kind of overlay operations kind of assume, or what kind of makes them work really well, is when you have a, okay, I'm switching out from another card. Here it comes. So the idea is that this lower left corner is basically the same in So if we're comparing this raster with this raster, I can get these guys to line up because the lower left corner is the same, right? And I can get them to line up because the cell size is the same. And I can get them to line up because the extent is the same. And so what I'd like to say is that when you do overlay, you ideally, your rasters kind of snap together. And what I mean by that is that they have the lower left corner is the same, right? LLC, lower left corner, cell size. This is partly the kind of alignment. So, and that's from the lower left corner. It's also from the basic, the spatial reference system, which we're keep on talking about but without really talking about. So we'll talk a little bit more about the spatial reference system as things progress. And what else? The extent. Fair enough. So what we'd like to do is come up with a way that whenever we do an overlay analysis, or even whenever we kind of generate a new raster that we're going to use in some kind of overlay analysis, that we kind of make sure that the rasters snap together. And so this kind of mama raster idea is that we're going to choose, the mama raster idea is that we're going to choose a raster in our analysis from which we always borrow these parameters when we are doing an overlay operation or whenever we're making a new raster. Does that make sense? So in this case, we are gonna make a new raster. In this case, we're kind of, we're doing an operation in preparation for eventually doing some overlay analysis. And so that's, I think that's the basic idea. The mama raster is basically saying that we're going to pick a raster who's going to be kind of like mom, who's always providing the spatial structure for all of the kids. And the kids are basically always going to be made from the mom. Is that fair enough?